to the world, to the wicked world. Hear the word of the Lord God Most High, the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. Hallelujah. For I know you, and I know that your hearts are wicked and full of deceit, says the Lord. You've been liars from the beginning, even as your God, your father, is the father of all lies, even Satan, the slanderer, the accuser of the brethren, who has been a slithering snake in the garden of God since the very beginning. Hallelujah. For the Lord God Almighty reigns from on high. And the Lord wants you to know, all ye children of the earth, the Lord God Almighty, the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, he reigns, he is sovereign, he is El Elyon, the Most High God. And his will shall be done on earth as it is in heaven. He will bind your God and cast him into the pit of darkness forever and ever and ever. The Lord asks you today, you are about to enter into the valley of decision. The Bible calls it in Hebrew the valley of Jehoshaphat. You're about to enter into the valley of decision, says the Lord God Almighty. Decide today whom you shall serve. Shall you serve the Lord God Almighty, the creator of heaven and earth, who sent his one and only begotten Son to die in this world for your sins? Or will you give your heart to the devil? Will you continue to go down that wide, straight path to destruction? Or shall you turn on the narrow road, the only road, the narrow way through the blood of Yeshua? For Jesus, Yeshua HaMashiach, Jesus the Messiah, he said, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No man cometh unto the Father except by me. Behold, the hand of the Lord is against thee, O enemies of God. Hallelujah. For my hand of destruction is upon this world, says the Lord. For he who keeps Israel neither slumbers nor sleeps. The hand of the Lord is against this world and against the wicked rulers of wickedness in this world. And God's hand is about to come down in judgment. For the hour is late, says the Lord. The hour is late, and the tempter is in the garden to tempt you this day. Whom will you serve? Choose this day whom you will serve. Will you listen to what the serpent said? Oh, God didn't really say that. Or will you listen to the voice of the command of the Lord your God? For the Lord said, my sheep know my voice, and they answer not to another. For behold, destruction cometh as a flood upon this world. America, you have denied your God. You have denied your creator. You have denied the one that founded you. Therefore, the Lord will deny you in heaven, as you have denied the Lord before men. The Lord will deny you before our Heavenly Father. To stay the hand of destruction. The Lord has stayed his hand and stayed his hand to bring destruction on the United States. But the Lord has lifted his hand of protection off the United States. If you are not a born-again Christian, you must immediately, without delay, today is the day of salvation. You must give your heart to the Lord Jesus Christ. You must surrender your life. For the Lord said himself, for God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, whomsoever shall believe in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. The Lord Jesus said, if you want to enter into the kingdom of heaven, you must be born again. Give your life to the Lord Jesus Christ, says the Lord. The hour is at hand. The day of destruction is near. The night is over. The summer is over, and you are not saved. The Lord is about to harvest his bride, remove his people, snatch away his bride. It doesn't matter if you believe in the rapture or not. And the Lord is just, the reason why I stopped, because the Lord told me that he has a mighty harvest to receive from this world. Brothers and sisters, and those of you who are enemies of God, as the Lord instructed me in this video, enemies of the cross, the Lord says unto you, he has a mighty harvest in this world. He has a mighty harvest in this world, and the Lord will receive the reward of his suffering. He will receive every soul that God has given unto him. He will not lose any, save one, Judas Iscariot. The Lord will get all of the souls that the Father gave him. He will deliver every one of them for the reward of his suffering. And I will tell you the truth, the time is near, and now is when the Lord is coming for his bride. The Lord is going to make a way and part the heaven, and bring his bride home, whether you believe it or not. The time for debate of doctrines is finished and long past. The time for you thinking here, the time for you using your intellect to try to understand and calculate God and calculate His Word is over. For now, the Word, the Lord said, the byword for America will be survival. Survival. Just to survive. When it's day, you'll say, oh, word of God, it was night. And when it's night, you'll say, I pray to God, it was day. When it's winter, you'll say, I pray to God, it was summer. And when it's summer, you pray to God that it's winter. The byword for the United States from the Most High God, I speak to you now, forever and ever, will be survive. Just to survive, says the Lord. You will miss those days. Those days will be long gone of the salt and light of my church in this world. You will rue the day you rejected my people. Because Jesus said, when you've rejected the least of these, my servants, you've rejected me. And when you've rejected me, you've rejected the Father. So what people have done, says the Lord God Most High, you got confused. And when you heard the message, the gospel, you thought it was a message of man. You thought the person talking, you thought the messenger was the one who was saying those things. But the Lord says to you, it was me talking to you. How often have I wished to gather you, says the Lord, like a mother hen gathers her chicks. But ye would not, you would not submit to the Lord God Most High. If you're watching this video right now and you've been a mocker and a blasphemer of the things of God, it doesn't matter what you think about me, Brother Patrick or Pastor Patrick or whatever you want to call me. You can call me any name you want. It don't matter. I'm only a messenger. I've only been sent here by the Most High God to give you His Word. And the Lord's Word to you is, behold, today is the salvation. Destruction cometh like a flood on this world, and no one will escape except by one way. There is one, not two, not three, one way of escape. Spoken by the mouth of the Lord Jesus Christ in the Gospel of John, chapter 14, verse 6, the Lord Jesus said, I am the way, the truth, and the life. And no one comes to the Father except by the Lord Jesus Christ, except by me, he said. That is the word from the Lord for you. Time is up. Time is finished. You must choose this day whom you will serve. As for me and my house, we will serve the Lord. Even as Joshua said in Joshua chapter 25, he would serve the Lord with his house. And praise God. All of you who have chosen to give your life to the Lord Jesus Christ, praise God. If you have not, you want to pray, I'm going to pray with you right now. And it's not about saying in exact words that you hear people doing, talking about a sinner's prayer. It's that you speak to the Lord from your heart, and by His Spirit, He guides you in what to say. But basically, you say something like this. Pray with me. Lord Jesus Christ, I confess that I have broken God's rules. I am a sinner. I've lied. I've taken something that didn't belong to me. I've been a thief. I've blasphemed your name. I've deceived people. I've tricked people. I've slept with someone I wasn't married to. I've done all of these things that have made me a sinner and made me hide from you, Father, and be ashamed. But I come to you right now, Lord. According to your word, you said that anyone who comes to you would not cast out, Lord. Lord, you said all that call upon your name, Lord Jesus, would be saved. So, Lord Jesus, I confess I'm a sinner. I'm lost. I'm separated from God. I'm alone in this world, and I need a Savior. I need you, Lord Jesus, to redeem me, to save me. Lord Jesus, come into my life. Lord Jesus, I know I can't clean myself up. I know you can make it right. You can clean me up. You can set my feet upon a path to salvation and not to destruction. Into thy hands, Lord Jesus, I commit my spirit. I commit my life. I surrender to you, Lord Jesus. I surrender all unto you, Lord Jesus. And I just think of that song that they sing, all to Jesus I surrender, all to thee I freely give. Give all to Jesus, all to Jesus. I surrender all You can go look that song up and listen to it. All to Jesus I surrender. Hallelujah. May the Lord have mercy on you. May the Lord deliver you as you call upon His name. He's not a man that He should lie. The Lord is a promise keeper. Even as He set His rainbow in the air, as He did for Noah and said, I won't flood the world anymore, destroy the earth by a flood. The Lord is a promise keeper. That's what that rainbow represents. He's a promise keeper. The cross is the ultimate symbol that God is a promise keeper. He will redeem His people by His own blood. Can you imagine God came to earth as a man? Islam says go die for Allah and you go to paradise. But the Bible tells us God came to earth and died for us. God doesn't need us to die for Him. He died for us. Jesus said the devil, the enemy comes but to kill, steal, and destroy. But I have come that you might have life, and life abundantly, life to the fullest. Praise God Almighty. That's John chapter 10, verse 9 and 10. Praise God Almighty. And I ask you, if you prayed that prayer, just please contact me and tell me, hey, Brother Patrick, I've given my life to Jesus. I'm one of those ones that the Lord showed you. The Lord showed me a field of wheat when I was talking. That's when I began to talk about the sinner's prayer. The Lord told me He's got that harvest. Message me if you're one of those people. Praise God. Praise God. It's worth it. If one person sees this video and gets saved, all the time and effort of making a video and loading it up and all, it's nothing. It's nothing compared to one person getting saved. Praise God. All of our time to be spent to win one person to the Lord is worth all majesty, all glory in this earth would ever have to offer. To be a king on this earth is nothing. Even as King David said, who was a king? King David was a king of Israel and in the bloodline of the Messiah, as God had promised him. And he said in his words, in one of the Psalms, he said, it's better to be a doorkeeper in the house of God than dwell in the tents of the wicked. In other words, he's rather going to be opening the door for people to get into heaven than to be out there, you know, living high on the hog with the devil's people. And that's true, brothers and sisters. God bless you guys. May the Lord bless you and keep you. May this word pierce through your hard heart if you did not receive it. May the Lord bless you and may the Lord lead you into salvation today.